One day before the general election, the Sarpy County Election Commissioner's office is a bit crazy. In addition to all early voters, officials are juggling the final logistics for Election Day. KETV Newswatch 7's Daniel Wolfe begins our Commitment 2010 coverage. He's live in the Newsplex. Daniel?
Yeah, the day before the general election was a bit hectic in Sarpy County. The Election Commission's office is in a period of transition, making preparations a bit more tricky.
Organized chaos. That's what Sarpy County Election Commissioner Wayne Bennett calls his building as he and his staff prepare for Tuesday.
So we're ready to go for a long day tomorrow.
One look at the office shows the cramped quarters. The early voting room resembles a large walk-in closet, and boxes are piled high, ready to be picked up and taken to 87 different precincts.
These are our supply boxes that have everything that the inspectors need on election day, such as voting sleeves, tape for the poster, provisional ballots, and even I voted stickers.
But what makes things even more difficult is having to run the operation in multiple buildings.
The Election Commission office is over here. If you want to vote early, you come over here. Starting in the 2012 elections, it'll all be under one roof.
Voters will be able to early vote and register in the same place, and all of our inspectors and poll workers will be able to pick up their equipment and drop it off at the same place on election day. So we're very excited to be able to be housed under one roof starting next year.
But until then, the commission will make the most of what it has to work with, helping Nebraska's fastest growing county get out to vote.
We hope that people can remain patient and we can get them out in and out as fast as possible.
Now, the Sarpy County Board recently approved a lease for the new building that will house the Election Commission. Live in the Newsplex, Daniel Wolfe, KETV, Newswatch 7.
Thanks, Daniel. Douglas County also finished its election prep work today.
And this morning, the Douglas County Election Commissioner ran a ballot test. Take a look. This is what happens to ballots after they're submitted. Dave Phipps says he hopes this gives voters confidence that their ballots will be processed properly.
Show them how we go through, how we can, you know, take the ballots, count them by hand, and compare those results to what the machines are reading so that everybody knows that on election day, when we count the ballots, everything's going to run correctly.
Phipps says he expects about 39% of Douglas County voters to go to the polls.